I just got the new M5 MacBook Pro. And before I even open Final Cut Pro, there's a handful of apps I always install first. These are the tools that turn a brand new Mac into my full editing setup. Backups, shortcuts, automation, everything. Let's go through them. So, before I start installing anything, here's the plan. Up until now, I've been using my M1 Pro MacBook Pro. It's been a solid editing machine for years, but I figured it's finally time to upgrade. So, I picked up the brand new M5 MacBook Pro, the base 14-inch model, literally the cheapest MacBook Pro you can buy on Apple's website. It's got a 10-core CPU, 10-core GPU, 16 gigs of unified memory, and a 512-gig SSD. Over the next couple of weeks, I'll be testing it out to see if this base M5 is actually enough for my workflow, or if I should have waited for the M5 Pro, or maybe even the M5 Max later on. This video is part one of the journey. I'm calling it my M5 MacBook Pro Setup Series. Today, I'm walking you through all the apps I installed first on my new Mac, basically the tools that turn it from a blank slate into a ready-to-edit machine. In the next video, I'll put this base M5 MacBook Pro up against my M4 Pro Mac Mini and my older M1 Pro MacBook Pro to see how it handles real projects in Final Cut Pro. Then, I'll wrap up the series with my favorite accessories that make editing on this laptop way more comfortable and efficient. So, let's start with the basics. These are the apps I installed on my new MacBook Pro. The first thing I always set up is Backblaze. And that's because I learned the hard way why backups actually matter. A while ago, Apple made a change to macOS. When you control click on a drive or a memory card, right under eject disk, they added a new option, erase disk. When I first saw that, I thought, well, that's kind of stupid. But the thing with Apple is, sometimes their ideas seem dumb at first, and then later on, they start to make sense. So I decided to give it a shot. Every time I'd offload footage from my SD cards, I'd just erase the card right there in Finder, so it was ready for next time. And honestly, it worked great. Now, because I bounce between my MacBook Pro and my Mac Mini, I keep all my Final Cut Pro projects and media on an external drive. One morning, I was behind on a deadline, so I woke up early, before the kids were up, just trying to get a head start. Probably should have stayed in bed that day. Everything was going fine, until I plugged in my SD card to offload some B-roll. In my half-awake state, I right-clicked, and instead of erasing the SD card, I accidentally selected my external drive and hit erase disk. A little warning popped up asking if I was sure, and without thinking, I hit OK. A few seconds later, it hit me what I had just done. My entire Final Cut Pro library, my project, and all my footage, gone. I tried everything. Disk drill, EasyOS, Recovered, you name it. None of them worked. Every file was gone. I had to redo the entire project from scratch, and because it was all on an external drive, it wasn't included in my Time Machine backup. After that, I knew I needed a real backup system. I did a ton of research, and Backblaze was exactly what I was looking for. For around $100 a year, it gives you unlimited backup, your Mac, and any external drives connected to it. No data caps, no weird limits. You can download your lost files for free, or if you want, they'll even ship you a physical drive with all your data on it for a small fee. If I had been using Backblaze before the accident, my project would have been saved. So now, every new Mac I get gets Backblaze installed first, no exceptions. Once I got my backup system in place, next thing I install is Final Cut Pro, along with Motion and Compressor. These three are the core of my entire editing workflow. I edit probably 90% of my videos in Final Cut Pro. It's fast, reliable, and I just know it inside and out. The timeline feels natural to me, and it lets me focus on the creative side instead of fighting with the software. I also install Compressor right away, because that's what I use for my custom export presets and compressor droplets. It saves me time when exporting different versions of a video, like YouTube uploads, an Instagram reel, or backup ProRes Master, without having to tweak settings every single time. Then there's Motion. I use Motion whenever I need to make a custom graphic or add a realistic effect to a project. I'm also using Motion to learn plugin development. In fact, both my Final Cut Pro plugins, the FCP Essentials Toolkit and FCP Animated Scribbles, are built entirely in Motion. And while we're on the topic of Final Cut Pro plugins, one of the best investments you can make to level up your videos is high quality plugins. And if you're at all familiar with Final Cut Pro, you already know. No one even comes close to making plugins as good as today's sponsor, Motion VFX. The quality, variety, and versatility of their plugins are second to none. Whether you're looking for cinematic titles, smooth transitions, or complete effect packs, everything they make feels polished and professional. But what really makes Motion VFX great isn't just their plugins, it's also the little things, like M-Installer. This is a perfect example for this video. When I set up a new Mac, all I have to do is download M-Installer, sign in, and every plugin I've ever purchased for Motion VFX is right there, ready to install. No hunting for download links, no searching through emails, no activation codes, just log in and click install. And Motion VFX doesn't just stop there. They have a lot of plugins, and I mean a lot. With a Design Studio subscription, you can have basically everything Motion VFX has to offer just a couple of clicks away. An M extension makes finding what you need easier than ever. You can browse through Motion VFX's massive library of elements, and once you find what you need, just download it and drag and drop it straight into your timeline. It doesn't get any easier than that. And right now, Motion VFX is having their biggest sale of the year, the final price cut. From November 3rd through December 7th, you can get 30% off site-wide with the code FINAL, plus weekly flash sales with discounts up to 50% off. And if you've ever wanted to subscribe to Design Studio, all plans are 15% off, no code needed. But here's the big one. This is the last time you'll be able to buy Motion VFX plugins for Final Cut Pro with a perpetual license. So if you've had your eye on anything, now's the time to grab it. Once all my editing and plugin tools are in place, next thing I set up is ChatGPT. I use it before I even open Final Cut Pro. It's basically part of my pre-production workflow now. I use it to brainstorm video ideas, outline my script, and refine the structure before I start recording. It helps me get clear on what I actually want to say, which saves me a ton of time once I'm in the edit. I'll even use it to come up with title ideas, thumbnail concepts, or short punchy hooks that perform well on YouTube. Sometimes I'll even throw a rough draft of my script into ChatGPT and ask it to make it flow better, or make sure it sounds natural when I read it out loud. It's not about letting AI write for me, it's more like having an assistant that helps me get my ideas out faster. And for what I do, where every video has to balance story, information, and timing, that extra bit of polish makes a big difference. After that, I always install Alfred. It's one of those apps that's hard to explain until you use it. But once you do, you'll never go back. Alfred basically replaces Spotlight Search for Mac, but it's way more powerful. I use it to launch apps, find files, search a web, or even run custom commands, all without touching the mouse. Over the years, I've built a bunch of small workflows inside of Alfred to save me time every day. Things like emptying out the trash, copying file paths, or opening specific project folders with just a couple of keystrokes. It might sound small, but when you're balancing between editing, scripting, and managing files all day, those seconds really add up. Alfred just makes my Mac feel faster. It's one of those quiet upgrades that completely changes how smooth your workflow feels. The next thing I install is a few utility apps I usually get through setup, but you can buy these individually. These are tools that just make my day-to-day life smoother. Clean My Mac helps me keep the system clean, cleaning out junk files, managing startup items, and freeing up space when my SSD starts to fill up. CleanShot X is what I use for all my screenshots and screen recordings. It's perfect for recording plugin demos or tutorials without having to set up anything complicated. And it natively records computer audio, which is a big deal for me. I also use Quit All to instantly close everything when I'm done editing. Simple, but super handy. And Downy is my go-to for downloading reference clips or quick B-roll when I need something visual to test a project. They're small apps, but together they keep everything organized and efficient, which matters a lot when I'm jumping between multiple Macs. After that, I install Gling. It's an AI video editing tool that's actually made my workflow a lot faster. I use it mainly for my talking head videos where there is a lot of footage to go through. Basically, I upload my raw video to Gling and it automatically removes the silences, pauses, and retakes. What I get back is a clean rough cut that I can drop straight into Final Cut Pro. It's not perfect, but it saves me a ton of time, especially on those long projects where I might have an hour of footage just to get a 10-minute video. I still go through everything in Final Cut Pro to tighten things up and add visuals, but having Gling handle the first pass makes a big difference. It lets me focus more on the story and less on sifting through clips. Next, I install Insta360 Studio because I love 360 cameras. Right now, I'm using the Insta360 X5 and it's quickly become one of my favorite cameras to shoot with. It gives me so much flexibility when I'm filming. Whether it's B-roll, time lapses, or just those unique perspectives, you can't really get any other way. Insta360 Studio is where all that footage comes to life. it lets me reframe my clips exactly how I want. I can pan, tilt, or track the action after it's already been filmed, which is such a game changer. It also includes a bunch of built-in AI tools that help speed things up, like automatic subject tracking and horizon leveling. So I can get great looking shots without spending a ton of time keyframing. If I just need to use a single 360 clip in a regular project, Studio can also convert that file to an equirectangular format so I can reframe it directly in Final Cut Pro. That's perfect for when I want to add a quick 360 move into a normal timeline without having to do a full 360 edit. Overall, Insta360 Studio is what makes the X5 such a practical camera for me. It's fast, it's stable, and it gives me total control over every shot. After that, I install Things. It's my task manager, and basically that's how I stay organized. I use it to keep track of everything related to the channel. Video ideas, production steps, sponsorship deadlines, uploads, all of it. Each video gets its own project inside Things. I'll list out everything from filming and editing to thumbnail design and posting, and then I can check things off as I go. It's simple, clean, and syncs perfectly between my MacBook and all my other devices, which makes it easy to stay on top of things no matter where I'm working. I've tried a lot of different productivity tools, but Things is the one I always keep coming back to. It just fits the way I think. No clutter, no distractions, just a clear view of what needs to get done. And the last thing I set up are a couple of shortcuts that handle all my folder structures. I've got one that builds out my entire video project folder, things like footage, audio, screen recordings, and graphics, all perfectly organized in just a couple clicks. Then I have another shortcut that sets up my archive folder structure, which is where my Final Cut Pro library goes once the project's finished. That way, when I move everything over to my NAS, or backup drive, it stays consistent across every video. Both these shortcuts are included in my FCP Essentials Toolkit, which you can find linked in the description below. And that's my day one setup of my new M5 MacBook Pro. Nothing flashy, just the essentials that keep my workflow fast, organized, and backed up. Over the next couple of weeks, I'm really gonna put this thing to the test to see if the base M5 can actually handle my editing workflow, or if I should have waited for the M5 Pro or M5 Max models when they come out. So make sure to subscribe for the next video where I'll compare this M5 MacBook Pro against my M4 Pro Mac Mini and my M1 Pro MacBook Pro and Final Cut Pro. That's a lot of pros. I'll be running full project exports, playback tests, background renders, the works. After that, I'll wrap up the series with a video on my favorite MacBook Pro accessories, the gear that makes editing my laptop way more comfortable and efficient. You'll find links to everything I mentioned, including my FCP Essentials Toolkit, down in the description. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.